Welcome to Yun Tuition. I am Yun. Let's continue exploring the basic issues in research on weather and climate. So far, my talks have been focused on the Earth, the atmosphere, and the surface. Today, I'm going to Mars. In particular, I will report my recent discoveries of different mean surface temperatures of the Mars that have been investigated for over 60 years, and what is terribly wrong with the greenhouse effect hypothesis over there. So, are you ready? Let's go and have fun. It is said, most of the Earth's greenhouse effect comes from the water vapor and clouds, which together account for about 25 Kelvin of the 33 Kelvin, the warming on the Earth by the greenhouse effect, which implies the contribution from CO2 is less than 8 Kelvin. Should warming occur, the surface temperature is always higher than the planetary emission temperature. It is also known that the partial pressure of CO2 is about 40 Pascal compared with the air pressure, 1013 hectopascal on the surface of Earth, given the present CO2 concentration is 400 ppm. But what is the case on Mars? Well, the estimated mean surface air pressure is between 400 and 700 Pascal. Because 95% of Martian atmosphere is made by CO2, it is reasonable to say that the partial pressure of CO2 on Mars is around 600 Pascal, or at least 10 times higher than the partial pressure of CO2 on Earth. Does that mean the global warming on Mars due to greenhouse effect of CO2 should be over 10 times higher than 8 Kelvin or 80 Kelvin? That was my first question when my independent research on this basic issue began. As usual, I tried to search for the earliest paper, and then I found this one. Theoretical estimate of the mean surface temperature of Mars by Orins, Tang, and DeSanto, published in 1962. By inversely solving the radiative transfer equation, they derived both the highest average surface temperature of Mars to be 233 Kelvin with the greenhouse gases, and the lowest GMST, 219, in the absence of greenhouse effect. This indicates that the greenhouse warming on Mars is about 14 Kelvin, well below 80 Kelvin warming as anticipated. However, they made a conceptual mistake in obtaining the mean surface temperature in the absence of greenhouse gases. As I pointed out a few years ago, one cannot treat a planet as a black body when its reflectivity is not zero. Instead, one can treat it as a gray body with emissivity equal to 1 minus albedo, or reflectivity. To be exact, the emission temperature should be determined by this radiative balance condition at the top of the atmosphere. By algebraically removing the cofactor on both sides, the equation can be simplified. From this equation, the emission temperature is 223.9 Kelvin, rather than 219 Kelvin. As a result, their predicted greenhouse warming becomes only 9.1 Kelvin instead of 14 Kelvin anymore. Then I looked for recent research. Eventually, I picked up this paper published in 2012 by Robert Habernes, a NASA space scientist. Unlike other long and boring papers, the author proposed a paradigm shift idea, namely, an arithmetic mean surface temperature can be noticeably different from the emission temperature in the Stefan-Boltzmann law. To be specific, he argued that because thermal radiation flux is proportional to the temperature to the power 4, therefore, radiation flux should be expressed in terms of the mean temperature to the power 4, rather than the global mean surface temperature, or GMST for short. Here is his mathematical proof. Assuming the local temperature T oscillates as a sinusoidal function of time, where A represents the amplitude of the variation in the local temperature, such as diurnal and latitude variations. Apparently, a fourth root mean of the T to the power 4 is always larger than a mean temperature T, as long as A, the amplitude, is not zero. On Mars, as argued by Haberle, A could be very large, and the change could be nonlinear. As a result, the mean surface temperature relevant to the Stefan-Boltzmann law can be significantly underestimated. He introduced the surface effective temperature, or T sub SE, to denote his new mean surface temperature. According to Haberle, this temperature can be obtained from a NASA Mars General Circulation Model, close to 214 Kelvin. He also used 201 Kelvin for the traditionally averaged surface temperature for Mars, which is 14 Kelvin lower, as shown in this diagram. Do you remember the maximum greenhouse effect predicted in 1962 is also 14 Kelvin? What a coincidence. But what is the temperature 209 Kelvin in both equations, you may ask? It is the emission temperature of Mars in the absence of any greenhouse gases. But how did he get that? Good question. From this radiative balance condition first used by Orrin and et al. In 1962. Notice, Haberle used 0.23 for the planetary albedo of Mars, rather than 0.15 used by Orrin et al. Using the solar constant of Mars, 570 watt per meter square, this equation gives the emission temperature 209.74 Kelvin used by Haberle. For the sake of simplicity, we just used 209 Kelvin here. In this way, he concluded the true greenhouse effect on Mars should be positive 5K or warming, that is 214 minus 209. Without adopting his proposal, the greenhouse effect on Mars would be negative 80 Kelvin or 201 minus 209. Which means cooling. That's to say, CO2 and other greenhouse gases actually make the surface of Mars 80 Kelvin colder without adopting Haberle's new definition of GSMT. Now, the greenhouse effect is positive 5K, according to him. However, as I have found it out, Haberle made the same conceptual mistake as Orrin et al. Did over 60 years ago, as I discussed earlier. The correct emission temperature of Mars in the absence of any greenhouse gases should be 223 Kelvin rather than 209 Kelvin. This implies the greenhouse effect is negative 9 Kelvin or 214 minus 223. Got it? In summary, the Martian surface temperature would be 223 Kelvin without any greenhouse gases, neither 209 Kelvin nor 219 Kelvin. The newly defined GMST 214 Kelvin proposed by Haberle in 2012 is still 9 Kelvin lower than the emission temperature 223 Kelvin. As a result, the greenhouse effect on Mars, if there's any, makes the surface of Mars 9 Kelvin colder. Thank you for your patience if you have watched the whole talk. please consider making a regular donation to make this channel glow and grow like a spark at dawn. See you next time.